This was a very interesting and fun project. I think you'll like it. This Eagle unit was a kind of a self-contained one-piece unit with its own power supply, but it wasn't very good for a float tube or a belly boat. And what we're going to do is we're going to fix that. Let's get started. All you need is a Phillips screwdriver, a line crimper, some electrical tape, and a sharp knife. You start by taking the unit off the plastic case and go ahead and disassemble the transducer while you're at it. And now we're going to take that Eagle unit and put it on this L bracket and put this L bracket on the battery case. The wiring can get a little tricky. Just take your time. Take the battery out, remove the little clamps. Okay, take the short end of the power cord and cut off the connector. I'm a little old school here, so I use my sharp little knife to do the stripping. You got the lead stripped out, clamp the connectors on there, and then I like to tape them to where they can, will kind of stand out. All right, makes it easier to put onto the battery. See? Okay, make sure the power cord goes through the little slot in the cover. And screw it all down, and you are in business. And as you can see, it swivels left and right and up and down, which will allow you to adjust it to the perfect viewing angle. Okay, we're almost done. We're going to attach the transducer to the bracket. The bracket's really cool. It allows you to adjust the transducer to every angle necessary. Now it's a matter of putting the strap on. And don't forget that you can use a zip tie to tie your extra cabling up onto the battery box. And there you have it. And the end result is you have a fish finder, power supply, and transducer all on one strap. Works perfectly for belly boats. If you've got a problem with a fish finder mount, they've got the solution. Check them out.